Hello, sir. Are we presenting Christmas night with the tarts, sir? Oh, suits you. Are you a little nervous, sir? Never mind. Slip you into your DJ, sir. Come along. Oh, DJ, sir. Sounds a little like BJ, doesn't it, sir? Oh, suits you. Oh.
What about you, sir? We out with the lady last night, sir. Oh, did you want it, sir? Oh, suit you, sir. Suit you. Was it a lady, sir? Huge hands, sir.
Hairy forearms, sir.
Prominent Adam's apple, sir.
Thick, muscular calves.
What size shoes, sir?
Oh, suit you, sir. Oh,
suit you, sir.
Oh, have you ever been to Rio de Janeiro, sir?
Were you ever in Quebec, sir? Hmm? Oh. Donkey riding, sir.
Riding on a donkey?
Hey ho, sir. Where we go? Donkey riding.
Suit you.
Suit you, sir.
Run along.
Suit you, sir.
And your hosts tonight are Messrs. Stephen Fry and Hugh Laurie.
Colleague, my colleague, and thrice my colleague. Where to begin?
I don't know. I really don't. It just seems like a...
Is dream too strong a word?
No, I don't think it is. No, I don't. Some people might say, you know, keep your powder dry, hold back the word dream for when you really need it, for an emergency. But to those people, I would just say...
A dream, then. A dream for my colleague and I to be presenting this, the revival of A Christmas Night with the Stars. The very words are like... the release of a warm, sticky fluid.
It's our job to be your hosts for this evening. We'll be acting really as a sort of comedy darkness in the midst of which all these stars can shine during the course of the show. And may I say, talking of shows, we have got an extremely tight package.
I'm so excited that I've started to have a nosebleed.
Well, I should just say, I mean, for those of you who aren't as old as I once used to be, might not actually remember what the BBC's original Christmas Night with the Stars was really like. Well, it used to consist of a lot of stars who used to get together at Christmas
night.
I think you're right. I think it was Christmas night, yes.
Thanks.
And they used to tell jokes, sing songs, generally ask about the place, having fun.
But then, in 1972, round about 2:30, on a raw, crisp, this nation of ours ate of the forbidden fruit and lost its innocence. A Christmas Night with the Stars was deemed irrelevant.
In the years that followed, we became a clever, detached, sophisticated, cool, post-modern, hair gel-wearing, time-out-reading, sun-dried, tomato-eating, that Mexican beer which tastes exactly like Arctic Light and costs four times as much drinking, nation of cynics. If it moves, put inverted commas round it and sneer until your nostrils hurt.
North against south, rich against poor, man against woman, straight against slightly curved. We came to define ourselves as a nation not so much as by what we loved as by what we hated.
And we're not going to take it anymore, because I'll tell you what I hate, my colleague.
What's that, my colleague?
I hate hate.
Poetic.
So let this occasion of the revival of A Christmas Night with the Stars, there's that warm release again.
Let's use it as an opportunity to start an age of loving. For the next 70 minutes or so, why not just try to love each other? We can't, as a nation, all hold hands.
Yeah, of course we can't. It'd be silly.
That would be silly. But what we used to do and what we're asking you to do tonight is to hold the television. Just put your hands on the television. The remote control will do if you're too arsing lazy to get off the frigging
And we'll put our hands on the camera, like so. And I want our minds now to turn to all those that we thought we hated and to imagine now that we love them. Would you like to begin, my colleague? I love you, Virginia Bottomley.
I love you, Moral Maze Team.
Hey, Richard Littlejohn, crazy about you.
I love you, Michael Schumacher.
Markian Lewis.
Hey, Jeff. Jeffrey Archer, love your ass.
David Hasselhoff, will you marry me?
Good. A good start. So now, please, Mr. Man with unsightly headphones, will you strike up a vamp if you have one handy
because now it's time to check some names.
That's right. In our tight package tonight, Sandy Shaw,
Alexei Sales,
Alan Partridge,
Ronnie Corbett,
Reeves and Mortimer,
The Real McCoy,
Ramsey Nesbitt,
and Paul Whitehouse and Charlie Hickson.
But first, we're going to show you how it used to be.
Very important when making mulled wine to try and make it taste nice. a surprising number of people forget that, so, you know, if you can, try and remember.
Valuable tip there. Christmas. It's strange to think, isn't it, that all those years ago, in a small place in the Middle East, a baby was born who one day would grow up and buy Harrods. Strange, too, to think that 25 years later, in the Northeast, two babes would be born who, after years of struggle and problems with the police, would grow up to take British comedy by the scruff of the neck and give it a damn good kissing. I'm talking, of course, about Vic Reeves and Bob Mortimer. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please put your buttocks together for the Petermains? You know, Christmas, ladies and gentlemen, is a time, isn't it, when our thoughts inexorably turn towards January sales. Well, we here at the A Christmas Night with the Stars team can offer you something slightly better. A December sale. More than that, an Alexei sale.
You see, that doesn't work now, does it?
What?
Well, sale, it's spelt differently. There's a Y. Alexei sale, S-A-Y-L-E. There's a Y in
it. You do it.
Right. Well, you either love him or you love him a lot. He's round, he's friendly, he's a big, bouncing ball of entertainment, Mr. Alexei Sale.
With a Y.